जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। एंड नाउ सी स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी दोज चैप्टर्स व्हिच हैड बीन टॉट बिफोर समर वेकेशन ऑन अ डिफरेंट प्लेटफॉर्म। सो बिकॉज द क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम दोज चैप्टर्स विल ऑल्सो बी आस्क्ड इन योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जामिनेशंस, so it is better that we revise those chapters once again in a proper way. So that's why that we are going to begin from today onwards to revise those chapters. And for this, that first of all I am going to teach you the first lesson from main course book, that is Flamingo, and the first chapter is actually the last lesson. Ironically, it is going to be the last lesson, and for that, first of all, that I'm going to share the important points, main points which is important for you to understand the chapter. So I am going to share those important points on your screen. First of all, we will discuss that, and then we will go through the text thoroughly. So just wait for a minute, students. I am going to share those important points. Now you can see here that the chapter number one, the last lesson by Alphonse Daudet, and this chapter, the last lesson, ironically that it is chapter number one in our syllabus. Now let us see the first of all the main points. And because that before I have already told that before beginning of any of the chapter, it is very important to study, to discuss, to know about this main points. It will be easier for you to understand the chapters. So first of all, let us know something about the author. Now remember students, that questions will not be asked from the author, but even then we should know something about the author. So let us know something about the author, Alphonse Daudet. Alphonse Daudet is considered to be one of the most iconic names of French literature, and he is unlike many famous writers in the world history, very well, not very well educated, but he wrote his first novel at the age of 14, and his works drew inspiration from instances of his life. And here one thing is very important regarding the author, that Alphonse Daudet is one of the handful writers that who portray human emotions in a very realistic manner. Remember students, that he has portrayed human emotions in a very realistic manner, and that example we can also see through this chapter, the last lesson. And now students, we can see then the second point. Before beginning of the any chapter, it is very important to know the introduction of the story. It will be easier for us then to understand the story. And here, as much as this chapter, the last lesson concern, it is set, means the last lesson is set in the days of Franco-Prussian War in 1870 to 1871, which was 14, and the war was fought between France and Prussia. And in the war, France was defeated by Prussia, and at that time the Prussia was led by Bismarck. Then Prussia consisted of what now are the nations of Germany, Poland and parts of Austria. Means these three nations were combined at that time, and they were known as Prussia. And now with the dictatorial presence of the Prussian army in these districts, these people have been deprived of their right to learn their own language. Means that is French language. Means French people of two districts, Alsace and Lorraine, remember students, these two names of these two districts, Alsace and Lorraine, and the people of these two districts were deprived of learning their own mother tongue, that is French language. According to an order from Berlin, French would never be taught in the school of Alsace and Lorraine, and they would have to learn German instead of French language. And this sudden transformation makes them realize the worth of what they have lost. And the people of Alsace and Lorraine, remember student, these two districts, I remind you because you will have to use it again and again while you will write the answer. The people of Alsace and Lorraine, these were the two districts of French which had been occupied by the Prussians. So the people of Alsace and Lorraine, along with the school teacher M. Hamel, mourn this loss, and they reproach themselves for having taken their mother tongue and their identity for granted, because they thought they had taken that it is their mother tongue. They kept on postponing to learn their mother tongue, and because they had taken it for granted, that means they can learn their mother tongue at any time, but they were deprived of their mother tongue all of a sudden. And M. Hamel leaves them with love and respect for their mother tongue, and parts with the hope that they would be able to bring France back to its former glory, because that he received an order from Berlin that he will have to leave the place, because from the next day German will be taught instead of French language in all the schools of these two districts, Alsace and Lorraine. And because of that, M. Hamel had to leave the school where he had been teaching for last 40 years after giving his last lesson. Means after teaching the last lesson in the school. Now, students, let us see that another important topic, that is the theme. Theme of the lesson, theme of the chapter, the last lesson. And here that we can see that in this story, the last lesson, the writer points out that it is actually unwise approach to postpone learning of things for one reason or the other. And the people of Alsace in France do not pay attention to the study of their own mother tongue, that is French language, in their school. But when France is defeated by Prussia, and the Prussian rulers imposed that French will no longer be taught in the school in Alsace, they realize their mistakes. When means they impose their own language, that is a foreign language, means German language, on the French speaking people, then they realized their mistakes. And when the Germans try to impose their own language on the French people, they realize the actual value of their own language, of their mother tongue. And then they receive their last lesson in their own mother tongue, in French language, and they are forced to abandon their own language. And in this way, the author Alphonse Daudet depicts how the Prussian rulers wanted to rule over the minds and hearts of the people of France. And in this way, the story also reflects the cruelty of war, which makes the victorious people rude, arrogant, proud, and insensitive to the human feelings, as they don't have any respect for other nation or for other nation's language. Sorry. Now, students, let us see the next topic, that is title. And in this case of this chapter, that justification of the title is very important, because this question has already been asked in your board examination once. Justify the title, the last lesson. And without understanding the entire story, it is really very difficult to justify the title, because the title is the last lesson. Why it became the last lesson? Let us try to understand. Now, see students, the story revolves actually around the last lesson, which was taught by M. Hamel, the schoolmaster, the school teacher, the language teacher as well. Means M. Hamel was teaching, had been teaching French language. And as now, French would no longer be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. So it is in fact turned out to be the first lesson for these Frenchmen, that who suddenly realized that they were losing their identity. They were not losing only their mother tongue, the right to speak, to read or write their own mother tongue, rather they were also losing their identity, which till now they had taken for granted. And if we take our life and all that we have been gifted with for granted and fail to cherish them, then chances are that we will lose it in times to come. And this is exactly what happened with the people of these two French districts, that is Alsace and Lorraine. Now, it is important to understand that they lost their chance to hold on to their identity as they had never bothered to learn their language, and it was a matter of disrespect, it was a matter of shame for them that being a Frenchman means they could pretend to be the Frenchman, but they were unable to read or write their own mother tongue, that is French language. Hence, the title, The Last Lesson, is quite apt as it teaches the people of Alsek and Lorraine and the readers as well that the lessons of life must be learned well in time, lest life should take away the opportunity, as it happened with the people of Alsek and Lorraine. And that's why that M. Hamel, the teacher who had been teaching there for last 40 years, had to and he had been teaching the mother tongue, his own mother tongue, means that is the French language, and all of a sudden he have to leave. He had got the notice that the next day that he will have to leave the place, because that his mother tongue, means their mother tongue, will be replaced by a foreign language, that is German. And that's why he decided to give the last lesson to his students, and along with the students some villagers were also present there, and he had given the last lesson, he had given the last message along with his last lesson to the French speaking people, to the French people. And that's why the title is quite appropriate and logical. Now let us see, students, that message, because this lesson, the last lesson, the author wants to convey a strong message through this chapter. What is that? Let us see. The story, the last lesson, conveys the message that it is unwise to neglect the learning of one's mother tongue. It is through our mother tongue that we can preserve our identity, our culture, and even we can enjoy our freedom. And this spirit of message was rightly conveyed to the students in the villages, not only students, rather to the villagers also, because that you know, that prominent village people were also present at the time of the last lesson. And that the message that was conveyed by M. Hamel, that when M. Hamel wrote as large as he could, Vive la France, live long France, means he could not last at the time of the last lesson, at the time of dismissing the class, that he became so emotional that he was unable to speak, he could not convey his message verbally. So that's why he had written there on the blackboard as large as he could, Vive la France, means long live France. And that was an absolute message to protect their language. In that way he had appealed to the people to protect their language and respect their language. And now students, apart from this, that we can also see that character, that two important characters are there. The most important character is M. Hamel, the school teacher, and the second important character is French, the narrator. He is a schoolboy, he is the student of M. Hamel, And though he is a student, but he is the keen observer. He had, you know, that taken a minute observation of each and everything what happened there. So these two characters are important. And let me tell you one more thing, that the character sketch of M. Hamel had already been asked in board examination. So separately you will also have to do writing practice of the character sketch of these two characters, Mr. M. Hamel and French, that who is the narrator. And many things that we can get when we talk about the M. Hamel, that M. Hamel is portrayed as a devoted teacher. He reflects his love for his country when he writes Long Live France, means Vive la France, with a piece of chalk on the blackboard before dismissing the gathering. And in short, that he is a devoted teacher, a strict disciplinarian, and a true patriot. He was very emotional as well, and he proved to be an ideal teacher. And there are so many things you can describe his merits, demerits, along with the examples from the text. And after studying the text, after studying the story, that the things will be clear to us. And then the French, who is a school-going boy, that who is carefree and easily distracted. He does not attach much does not give much importance to learning, and like other people of all say. And he is a victim of suffering from the loss of the right to read, write, or speak, or learn his own mother tongue. And that also created a patriotic feeling in him as well, when he came to know that today his teacher was going to give the last lesson. Since he did not pay any attention to study, he did not like his books, he did not like his teacher, and he did not like to study. But when he came to know that this is going to be the last lesson, and after that that he will not be able to learn his mother tongue, then he became quite emotional. He filled with patriotic feelings, and then he attended that last lesson with such an intention that he had understood everything what had been taught there. And he was very much angry also on the people, on the, you know, Prussian people. And means all these things in detail that we will study by study through the thorough explanation of the text, the last lesson. And now students, that in this way that we have, since we have discussed all those important points, now it's time to see the to study the text. So for this I am going to share the text, means the story, on your screen. Now here it is, students. Now you can see that this much we have already studied about the author, no need to study. But here that you can see that means you can go through in your own way. And now here we can see that Prussia then consisted of consisted of what now are the nations of Germany, Poland, and parts of Austria. And in this story, French districts of Alsace and Lorraine. Remember, students, as I told, these two names, Alsace and this Lorraine. These two are the names of the districts of France which had been occupied by the Prussian, and they wanted to impose their own rule. They wanted to impose their own language on the French speaking people of these two districts, Alsace and Lorraine, because they have passed into the Prussian hands. And now let us see the story. These are the important words you can understand. You can also write there the meaning of these words. When I explain, then I will also explain those words. And you have to, while you since I think that you have already written all the question answers and everything, if you have not written, so you can also focus on the word meaning. Now let us begin the chapter. And here we see that I started for school very late that morning and was in great dread of scolding, especially because M. Hamel had said that he would question us on participles, and I did not know the first word about them. I started for school. Who started for school? I is the narrator of the story. And who is the narrator? French. And the narrator, French, says that when he started for school very late, because that he was not interested in school, means in study. So usually it happened, and that day also, that when he started to go to school, it was already late, and that morning, and was in great dread of scolding, and that he knew that he will be scolded when he reaches the school. He will definitely be scolded by the teacher, especially because M. Hamel had said. And why that he was in he was scared that he will be scolded? Because that M. Hamel, means his teacher, M. Hamel, remember students, the most important character. And M. Hamel, his teacher, had said that he would question us on participles, because he had given homework to learn the rules of participles to all the students. And French says that I did not know the first word about them. And French says that he even did not know the first word about them. And that's why, means there were two reasons because of that he did not want to attend the class that day. First one is that he became late, and the second one that he had not completed his homework. And because of these both reasons, that he did not want to attend the class that day. And for a moment I thought of running away and spending the day out of doors. And for a moment he thought that it would be better not to go to school, rather to run away and spend the day out of the doors, out of schools. And it was so warm, because now he is describing the atmosphere outside of the school, and he says that it was so warm, so bright, because outside the school that morning, it was a beautiful morning, it was quite warm and so bright, and the birds were chirping at the edge of the woods. He could hear the chirping of the bird sounds. And in the open field back of the sawmill, the Prussian soldiers were drilling, and then Prussian soldiers were also, you could also see that Prussian soldiers were, means on the back of this, there was a sawmill, on the back of the sawmill, the Prussian soldiers were, drilling, they were doing their exercises. So all these things were quite attractive for him. So it was all much more tempting, much more attractive, alluring than the rules of participles. He thought, means French thought. But I had the strength to resist and hurried off to school. Even then he decided to go to school because he thought that he had the strength to resist. He could oppose, he could control his emotions, and then he decided to go to school to attend the class. And so hurriedly he started going to school. I think that we should stop the class today, students, because that time is about to be over. Today we will be continued with the explanation of the chapter. Till then, since you, I think that you have already studied, if you have the book, it is better that to go through the story, because I will teach in a little bit faster way these chapters. But remember, students, those who have not written the question answers, I will also keep on telling you that what are the important questions. It is not only important for half yearly examinations, for internal examinations, rather those questions will also be important for board examination papers. So those questions which I will tell you to attempt, so definitely you write according to the word limit in your copy. If you have done already, no problem. If you have not done, you must do that. That's all for today, students. Thank you for joining me, and have a nice day.